Hello everyone, welcome to Study Time. In this video, we are going to see Class 4 Maths Chapter 3, A Trip to Bhopal. If you are a parent or teacher or student of Class 4 watching this, I would like to share few things. I post videos for Class 4 subjects, Maths, Hindi, Computer, Chapter Wise Fully Solved. Also, Class 4 EVS English worksheets. I am also planning to post model question paper for periodical test, summative assessment, full all subjects fully solved. For other classes, I am posting maths videos for class 1, class 2, class 3 and basic Hindi and grammar I am teaching. So you are at right place. If you are not finding any notification from my channel, you can just go through the playlist or I'll give the link in the description box. You can just click on the playlist and search for the video you want. I made this video with KV or NCERT textbook as reference. I have also analyzed few question papers and learning objectives of this chapter. So this video would be useful for understanding the concept. You can find all the solutions in this video, which will be easier for you to attend the exam. I am going to give you overview of basics that you need to know before we actually get into the video, because the objective of this chapter is to make kids use of these basics in real time. I'm going to just fastly go through the basics. Place value. So what is place value? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, 10 crores, and this goes on. So whenever a number is given, you should know the place value and you should also know to write the number name for it. So I have given an example and written number name, the given number. So I am going to give one example of how to write greatest and smallest number using the given number. Here the number I gave is 372. Here which is the smallest number? 2 is the smallest number. Next to that, 3 is the immediate greater number. Greatest number is 7. So if you want to write smallest number, you should start from smaller, next immediate greater number, next greatest. So 237 is the smallest number. Next, greatest number is 732. So you have to write greatest number, immediate greater number, then you have to write the smallest number. So when you want to remember, you can remember like this. For smallest number, you have to write ascending order. For greatest number, you have to write descending order. Next, you should be very clear about number operations of 3-digit addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. I'm not going to teach all those things here. We'll just see what you have to do for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So I have given few examples. You can just solve the examples. Just pause the video and solve the examples, whether you can check whether you can solve all those things. First, I have given 3-digit number with 4-digit number addition. Next, subtraction, 5-digit number with 3-digit number. Next, find the product of following numbers. You can do box multiplication, which you have learnt in class 3. Next, division. So 216 divided by 2. Try to find quotient and remainder of this. So next, keywords of different number operations. So if you are trying to solve any direct problem, you can judge based on the symbols they give. Plus means they give plus symbol, minus means they give minus, multiplication symbols you know. In case of word problems, you need to know some keywords for different number operations. Suppose for addition, you will be having add, sum, in all, both, plus, combined, overall, altogether. So those are the keywords for addition. Next, for subtraction, you need to know, like, if they give how many more, subtract, less, minus, how many less, how many they need to, remaining, take away. If they give those things, then you have to subtract. Multiplication, how many times. So how many, if you get, then you can write, do multiplication. Or products, how many times it is, then you have to do multiplication. Division, so how you divide this, how it is separated, how quotient, how the particular group is divided to each, then you have to do division. Solve the given word problems. I have given this 4 word problems. You can just try to analyze whether you have to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. So just pause the video and try to solve. I'm going to just explain what is given in that. First one, Ajay has rupees 500. He wants to buy a max reader for rupees 262 and a story book for rupees 182. Does he have enough money? So what you have to do? First, you have to add 262 plus 182 and then subtract with 500. So if you get any reminder, then you can say that he has money. If it is not, then you can say that Ajay has no money, not enough money. You can say like that. A factory produces 2346, 4152, 1007 bulbs in 3 days. Find the total number of bulbs produced in 3 days. Just you have to add. A bus has a seating capacity for 58 students. How many students will travel in 16 such buses of the same capacity? You have to just multiply. Susie's father repaired the bookshelf in a reading room. If he has 210 books to be distributed equally on the 10 shelves he repaired, how many books will each shelf contain? So you have to divide. Next, properties of arithmetic operations. See, first one, 2 plus 4 equal to 4 plus 2. So whenever you change the order of addition, it will be same. 0 plus 5 equal to 5 plus 0 equal to 5. 4 minus 2 is not equal to 2 minus 4 because 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 minus 4 is minus 2. 4 minus 0 is not equal to 0 minus 4. 2 into 4 equal to 4 into 2, that is 8. 0 into 4 equal to 0, 4 into 0 equal to 0. 9 divided by 5 is not equal to 5 divided by 9. 0 divided by 7 is 0, that is any number which is divided by 0 gives infinity, whereas 0 divided by any number gives 0. Next, trip plan. This chapter is about a trip. So before go into the actual lesson, we'll discuss few things about trip. So as a kid, what trips you have gone? So you would have gone an educational or a school trip or a family trip. So what are the things you will plan for a trip? First thing, you will plan for a budget. Based on the budget only, we will choose the place. Next comes date and time. So we'll fix one date and time. Then we'll discuss about transportation, whether to travel by road, water, air. So by which means of transport we are going to reach that place. Next is distance. We'll calculate the distance, traveling time and food arrangements. Next, expenses. We'll discuss about expenses that we are going to spend. Food expenses, travel expenses, hotel expenses. Next, things to carry. What are all the things to carry? So whether it is educational trip or school trip or family trip, we'll plan all these things. Next, trip to Bhopal. This is about a trip to Bhopal. I'm going to take you all to Bhopal. In a school, all children were planned to go for a trip. with their teachers. We'll see how many are going, how they are discussing, how they are planning, so how they enjoyed the trip, all those things we are going to see. So each class, I have given the number of children going for the trip. For class 1, 33 children are going. For class 2, 32. Class 3, 42. Class 4, 50. Class 5, 53. So after getting these details, each children were discussing about the number of buses needed. So let us calculate how many buses needed. If they get 4 buses, each bus has 50 seats, how many children will get seats? Will there be any children left without seats? For this, first you need to calculate the total number of children. Only then you can calculate the how many number of buses you need. So total number of children is 210. So 200 in 4 buses, 200 children can be occupied. Will there be any children left without seats? Yes, 210 minus 200, 10 children will be there without seats. Next, they were just discussing about the number of buses and waiting for the buses. But the buses they got are not big as expected. They got only mini buses. They started discussing about number of mini buses needed. So each mini bus can take only 35 students. How many mini buses are needed? So you have to divide 210 divided by 35. So 6 mini buses are needed. Next, the journey begins. Buses started at 9 o'clock. If they don't stop anywhere, they all can reach in 2 hours, that is around 11 o'clock. Travel distance is 70 kilometer. They have planned to stop at Bimbetka, which is 50 kilometer from there. If they go to Bimbetka, they will reach there before 10 o'clock, between 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock, or after 11 o'clock. So 50 total distance they can travel in 2 hours. So how long it will take to travel for 50 kilometers? So 70 kilometers they can travel in 2 hours. 50 kilometers they can travel between 1 to 2 hours. So that is I have given between 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock. Next, when they were traveling, they crossed Narmada River. The children started discussing about river, how long, how wide, and the water level of this river. So they were discussing all those things. So the bridge is 756.82 meter long and 500 meter wide. So the water level now is 400 meters below the bridge. The water level at rainy season is 15 meters below the bridge. So what is the difference between the water level of the Narmada in the raining season and now? So you have to just subtract 40 and 15, you'll be getting 25 meters. Next, during the journey, they stopped in the petrol bank. Each bus takes about 15 minutes to refill, and there are 2 buses to be refilled. So they stopped there for 30 minutes, which means they are late by 30 minutes. After filling the diesel, they gave rupees 3500. You can see in the picture. Look at the picture and find the cost of 1 liter diesel. So here I'll zoom and show you. Here the cost of 100 liter petrol is rupees 3500. Therefore, cost of 1 liter diesel is rupees 35. When you divide 3500 divided by 100, you will be getting 1 liter diesel, that is rupees 35. Next, they reach Bimbetka. What is Bimbetka? It is a place with lots of caves and cave paintings made by people 10,000 years ago. Now, the children are really excited to see the cave paintings. It is about 11 o'clock when they reach this place, Bimbetka. Children counted deer, bison, people on the painting. There were cave paintings, so children started counting what is there in that painting. They spent nearly 1 hour in that place. The guide tells them that there are 600 cave paintings in all. So after spending 1 hour in that place, it's time to leave Bimbetka. Next, they are now moving towards Bhopal. They should reach there in less than 1 hour, at about 1 o'clock. So it was lunchtime. The children are hungry by this time, so they take out their lunch packs. Biscuits, oranges and bananas are also distributed in all the buses. Each child is to be given one orange, one banana and 5 biscuits. All the children take oranges and biscuits, but 38 children did not take bananas. How many oranges, biscuits and bananas are distributed? So each child has got one orange, one banana and 5 biscuits, but 38 children did not take banana. So we'll see how many oranges, biscuits and bananas are distributed. Total number of students already we saw as 210. Each student was given one orange. So it is, they gave 210 oranges. 5 did not take banana. So 38 children did not take banana. So 210 minus 38. You will be getting 172. So number of biscuits distributed to each student is 5. So 210 into 5, 1050. So 210 oranges, 172 bananas and 1050 biscuits were distributed among all the students going to the trip. Hope you understand this question. Next. After finishing their lunch, students started asking puzzles to pass their time. We'll see what are the puzzles the children discussed. So one child asked, tell me the number which is exactly between 100 and 150. What is the number? So it is 125. Next, one child asked, I gave 4 toffees each to 4 of my friends and 3 toffees are left with me. How many toffees did I have? So 4 into 4 is 16. So 16 he gave to his friends, but he has got 3 left. So the total number of toffees that child had is 19 toffees, because 16 plus 3 is 19. What numbers can you make using 357? You can make 357 and 537. What others? 375, 573, 753, 735. A number becomes double if it is increased by 8. What is the number? So 8 is the number. So 8 into 2 is 16. So it is doubling. So if you add again that 8, 8 plus 8 is also 16. So the number is 8. Next, think of a number which can be divided by 2, 3 and 5 and comes between 25 and 50. For this, you should first multiply 2 into 3 into 5. So what is the answer? 30. So since that number comes between 25 and 50, you can write it as 30. If they give any other number range, so if you want to find a number which can be divided by 2, 3, 5, that comes between 50 and 75, you can write 60. Because multiple of 30. So here the answer is 30, because they have given clue that the number comes between 25 and 50. A small ant climbs 3 cm in 1 minute but slips down to 2 cm. How much time will it take to climb 2 cm? So first it will climb 3 cm, again it slips down 2 cm. So it would have reached only 1 cm. Again it will climb to 4 cm height and it will slips down to 2 cm. So totally in 2 minutes it will climb 2 cm. Next. Now they have reached the lake. It was very big lake with a small island in it. The lake looks very beautiful. There were lot of ducks making a loud noise. Some children gave popcorn to the ducks. It is time for boating. They have to choose which boat to take. There were different kinds of boats, each has a different ticket price and different trip times. So children were discussing which boat to take. Here the name of the boat, ticket price and trip timing is given. Now we'll see what happens in the boating. Indra and Banu first went into the motor boat and then took the oar boat. How much did they pay for both the boats? So here third one and fourth one is motor boat and boat with rows. So how much money means you have to add 25 plus 15. The answer is rupees 40. How much time did they take for both the rides? 25 minutes, 20 minutes plus 45 minutes. The answer is 65 minutes. One group of children went for the double-decker trip. They paid rupees 450 in total. How many children went for the double-decker trip? So first one is double-decker. 450 total paid divided by one price ticket. One ticket price. 450 divided by 30. The answer is 15 children. Next. Which boat makes two trips in 1 hour? 1 hour is 60 minutes. So which takes two trips in 1 hour? So is there any boat which takes 30 minutes? Because 30 into 2 is 60. So paddle boat will take two trips in 1 hour. Which boat takes less than half an hour to complete a trip? What is half an hour here? Half an hour meaning is 30 minutes. Motor boats takes less than 30 minutes to complete a trip because the trip time of motor boat is 20 minutes. Next, which boat gives them the most time taking the least money? What is the least money here is 15. But paddle boat and boat with oars also charges the same price, rupees 15 least amount. But boat with oars gives them the most time taking the least money because it has got 45 minutes. Next, Javed went twice for boating. He paid a total of rupees 40 and boated for 15 minutes. Which two boats did he take? So he paid 40 rupees and boated for 50 minutes. So he would have taken. So which timing if you add, it will be 50. So paddle boat and motor boat. Jav took the pedal boat and motorboat trips, which together cost him rupees 40. Also, the total time spent on both the boats is 50 minutes. So this is how they enjoyed boating. We'll see what happened next. Next, it's time for them to return. Children enjoyed different kinds of boats till 4 o'clock. It is time to return. Now they will not stop anywhere and they reached back in 2 hours. So they should reach Hoshangabad by 6 o'clock. So this is how the children from that place enjoyed the trip of Bhopal. They enjoyed well, isn't it? So let us discuss and find out, have you ever been on a school trip? How many children were there in all? How did you go and how far did you go? How much time did you take? Try to find out the cost of travel for each child. So next time if you go for any trip, you should be able to calculate and keenly observe these things. Next, practice time. There are 4 very old cave paintings, mark the oldest. Here 4 options were given: 4200 years old, 1000 years old, 8500 years old, 1300 years old. So which is greater here is 8500 years old. One bus can carry 48 children. How many children can 3 bus carry? 48 into 3 is 144. So the nearest option is 150. Which pair of numbers add to make more than 500? So you have to add all the options and check which is more than 500 when you add. Here the answer is 321 and 192. Next, what happened at what time? Draw lines to match. So you have gone through this video, so you can very easily mark it. Crossed the Narmada bridge at 9:10 a.m. Looked at Bimbetka paintings 11:30 a.m. at the petrol bunk 9:30 a.m. Boating in the lake 3 p.m. Had lunch 12:30 p.m. Returned to Hoshangabad 6 p.m. Hope this video is useful. Hope you enjoyed the trip to Bhopal. In this video, you have learned how to use arithmetic operations in real time, how to plan for a trip, what are the things you need to observe before going for a trip and after going for a trip, during the trip. So I hope this video is useful. I made this interesting and easy. Thanks for watching Study Time. Do subscribe and like, comment this video. More videos, useful videos are waiting for you. Thank you. Thanks for watching.